Right, so welcome back to the session. The topic is Atwood machine, and this topic is very important for NEET students. So look at this diagram. So this is a rotatable pulley, and this pulley will rotate either clockwise direction as well as anti-clockwise direction also, right? And I have two objects, one is mass M1 and the other one is mass M2. So these two masses which are connected by using a massless string, okay? And I mentioned clearly here, mass of the first object is more as comparing to the mass of the second body, right? So automatically, due to the difference in mass, the first body weight is maximum as comparing to second body. So the first body comes down and automatically the second body moves up, okay? So therefore, in this Atwood machine, we are going to calculate only two things. One is acceleration of the block and the second one is tension. Okay, so to calculate acceleration as well as tension, we will use only one equation, that is Newton's second law. Okay, so what is Newton's second law? Force is equal to mass into acceleration, and this force I'm going to split into two parts. One is action minus another one is reaction is equal to ma. Okay, now coming to the diagram, I told you already m1 is greater than m2. That means the first body coming downward, right? So whenever the first body is coming downward, the weight of the first block m1g, which is maximum as comparing to tension, so in that case m1g act like a action and tension is the reaction. So let us see, action is m1g minus reaction is tension is equal to m1 into a. Okay, so let us assume this is equation number 1 and leave it this first part, because whenever the first body is coming downward direction, automatically the second block is moving upward, right? So in this case the tension is maximum, that's why the body is moving upward, right? So in that case, tension is action, m2g is reaction. So T minus m2g is equal to m2 into a. So let us assume this is equation number 2. Now add 1 and 2. So what will happen? Minus T plus T cut. What is the remaining? m1g minus m2g is equal to m1 plus m2 into a. Okay, so in this we are going to calculate two things. One is acceleration, another one is tension, right? So from this equation, bring this acceleration left side. Therefore, acceleration a is equal to m1 minus m2 into g by m1 plus m2. Okay, so let us assume this is equation number 3. Now we are going to calculate the tension. So to calculate the tension we will use second equation. What is the second equation? T minus m2g is equal to m2a. So I'm writing again, T minus m2g is equal to m2a. So bring this minus m2g right side. Therefore T is equal to m2g plus m2a. So let us assume this is equation number 4. Look at here, acceleration a was present, but we know acceleration formula. So you can substitute here. So substitute equation 3 in 4. Therefore, T is equal to m2g plus m2 into a, means m1g minus m2g by m1 plus m1 plus m2. Okay, now this m2 is multiplied with m1, m2 is multiplied with m2. So let us see, t is equal to m2g plus m2 m1 means m2 m1 g minus m2 into m2 m2 square g by m1 plus m2. Now this m1 is multiplied with m2 and m2 also multiplied with m2. So t is equal to m1 into m2 means m1 m2 g plus m2 into m2 means m2 square g plus m2 m1 g minus m2 square g divided by m1 plus m2. So look at this equation. This is minus m2 square g and this is plus m2 square g cut. So what is the remaining? T is equal to m1 m2 g plus m2 m1 g. So we can write it as 2 times of m1 m2 g by m1 plus m2. Okay, so this is the tension and this is the acceleration. Okay, so I hope you understand. Thank you. Thank you so much.